What up, Doc?
I always wanted to do a movie on my own life. So, here I go. You can watch me when I'm happy. I got to laugh. When I cry, I have a great deal of remorse. When I get shot, when I go to jail, this is not the spot. When I die, it's a tragedy like Shakespeare, I guess. It's sad, but I got so many good memories.
He's a super freak! Super freak!
It's a coming of age story about temptation, weakness, fortune, and fame. That's the bomb right there.
It's been 7 years since his tragic death, but Tupac Shakur's influence can still be heard in the work of some of today's hottest rap stars.
Tupac's influence is on the entire hip-hop community. You had to see it, he's one of the best, period.
Tupac was definitely ahead of his time, so that's one of the reasons that his music can still live today.
The new movie, Tupac Resurrection, is more than just another ploy to make money off the memory of the late rap icon. The film was executive produced by Tupac's mother, Afeni Shakur, and it's told entirely in Tupac's own words.
I got shot. I always felt like I'd be shot, but I didn't think it was going to happen at that particular moment.
Tupac's remarkable story still resonates among his many fans, both in and out of the music business.
Yeah, I definitely want to see the movie.
I'm interested in seeing it.
I can't wait till it come out.
Some of Tupac's friends have already seen parts of the film, and their reviews are in.
When it first came on, it caught me off guard to hear him say what he said and just to see how it all came about. It's tight, clever.
I'm happy that people will get an opportunity to see Tupac and that it is told in his own words.
As a rapper, an actor, and an impassioned black activist, Tupac left behind a legacy that continues to inspire the hip-hop community to this day.
He became like what Martin Luther King or Malcolm X was to our generation. You know what I mean? That's when Pac talked, you listen. He had such an effect in the short time he was here on the generation and the culture of hip-hop.
Tupac found his voice as a rapper and was much admired for his brutally honest lyrics.
Tupac was a mean lyricist. You know, rhymes that can be heartfelt as soon as you hear them.
I think that honestly, Tupac was the greatest songwriter to ever live. He made it seem so easy, but you still could connect with him and the emotion was there and you saw a picture that he was trying to paint. And if there is a little bit of me, that's, you know, that's what I picked up from him.
When you hear Pac's voice, it's something about his voice that just grabbed you.
Out on bail, fresh out of jail, California dreaming. Soon as I step on the scene, I'm hearing Hoochie screaming, fiending for money and alcohol. The life of a West Side player with cowards out in a strong ball.
He always had a different style and he always came from the heart. You would always feel the words he was saying.
Tupac was the first rapper to make art out of the most intimate details of his own life, thus opening a new creative door for the rappers of today.
He used a large portion of his life in his music. I do exactly the same thing. My records.
Many men wish death upon me. Blood in my eye, dog, and I can't see. I'm trying to be what I'm destined to be.
He's someone that, you know, I've seen come before me that was able to speak exactly about his situations.
But Tupac rose above the testosterone-drenched rap scene with Dear Mama, a touching tribute to his mother.
When I was young, me and my mama had beef, 17 years old, kicked out on the streets.
He did things that a lot of rappers were afraid to do. He would go inside.
Dear Mama, that song alone in my life, you know, lasted about a year with me in the car, just playing it every day. If you had tough times with your mother, it made you like almost want to go, oh, Mom, you know, it made you want to like overlook everything you were going through.
It got me a couple of times. You know, I had to call my mom. Mama, I love you, Mama.
And even as a crack fiend, Mama, you always was a black queen, Mama. I finally understand for a woman it ain't easy trying to raise a man.
Both of us had mothers that were addicts. That was one of the things when we were younger that we really connected to and related to with one another. He told me he was writing the song Dear Mama, and I was like, damn. How does your mom feel about that? You know what I mean? And his thing is like, yo, it is what it is. He could reveal the undeniable connection that you have to your mother no matter what is going on. And I just always admired him for that.
In fact, Tupac wasn't afraid to reveal anything about who he was and what he felt, an artistic strategy that still works today for one of his staunchest admirers, Eminem.
If there is any way that me and him connect, it was just being able to take what's going on in our lives and be able to put it in words and write about it.
I said I'm sorry, mama. I never meant to hurt you. I never meant to make you cry, but tonight I'm cleaning up my closet.
It's almost like you're feeling it, so you write it. People feel like they can relate to you.
Just try to envision witnessing your mama popping prescription pills in the kitchen.
Later, you may think about it, like maybe I shouldn't have let people know that, but you know. I want people to understand what I'm going through, and this is the best way for me to put it.
Tupac actually put it a bunch of different ways. He was a man of many, sometimes contradictory moods.
He was a ball of fire and a ball of energy that if you rub the wrong way could turn at you and bite you.
Bad boy murdered on wax and kill. Mess with me and get your caps pill. You know.
One of the things that Tupac allowed other rappers to do to this day was contradict themselves. People go through different types of emotions and different types of things and points in their lives where they feel certain ways, you know? You can't just feel one way all the time. Something's wrong with you if you're happy all the time.
To me, like, Pac appeared like he was, like, out of control. The way he carried himself, the way he moved around, and that's what made him such an exciting entertainer.
So now I gotta throw away, floating in my black bin, trying to do a show a day. And wonder how I live with five shots. Brothers, it's hard to kill on my block.
It was somebody who really lived it, who was actually going through it, and who could really tell you about it. He was so likable because his style was fun, but at the same time, he was dealing with some real situations.
He was 10 Tupacs in one. He was so complicated. There was nothing simple about him. Nothing.
Coming up, some exclusive scenes from the extraordinary new movie, Tupac Resurrection.
You're in jail now, won't be any more rapping for a long time for you, huh? I'll be like, well, actually, my album is number one in the country right now. I just beat Bruce Springsteen.
And more reflections on the man and his art by those who knew and loved him.
He was just like me, you know what I'm saying? I felt like we were like brothers, like the same kind of people.
Tupac Shakur was one of rap's greatest artists and one of its first major stars, but he was also a fine actor, and in the new movie Tupac Resurrection, he tells in his own words his approach to creating a film character.
When I get a part, first I just try to find out, you know, how does this character feel, and like I make the person up in my mind. What does he look like? Try to put a face to him. Even though it's my face, I give him a walk and give him an attitude. All you really have to do is relate to your character.
Tupac's first starring screen role was in the 1992 movie Juice. It was a fairly routine ghetto crime drama, but Bishop, the menacing, gun-crazed character Tupac created for it, still resonates in today's hip-hop world.
You gonna do is shoot me in the elevator?
I was blown away with Bishop.
Bishop, that guy's in my neighborhood. The mentality that was expressed through that film, it lives right there on 134th Street, where I'm from.
When I first seen Juice, I mean, my reaction was probably like everybody's reaction was like, yo, this dude is crazy. It's kind of like you looked at him like, all right, he's acting, but is he really acting? Is he, like, crazy for real?
I read for the same part Tupac read for in Juice. But he won out. He go up in there with his line. I just hear flying all over the place. He left, and I'm looking at him like, this cat got it over here. When it comes to this movie thing, he got it.
Until Denzel did Training Day, I thought Pac's Bishop was one of the best bad guys I've ever seen. He just had it.
Check yourself, Q. You gotta snap some collars and let them motherfuckers know you there to take them out anytime you feel like it.
Naturally, there were some people who saw Tupac playing a scary, gun-wielding gangster who assumed he wasn't really acting, he was just playing himself.
I think psychologically, when you're trying to portray a character or trying to act something out, it's got to be something that's close to you. Otherwise, you're not going to really be able to play good. And I think that may be why he was so good at that role.
He wasn't Bishop. Pac was a smart, intellectual, revolutionary kind of cat.
And the real Tupac Shakur was actually trained at the Baltimore School for the Arts, where his best friend was Jada Pinkett, now Jada Pinkett Smith, a star in her own right. She knew Tupac the actor could play more than just crazy street hustlers, and she gave him a chance to show his real range.
I was just like, Pac, you gotta come on a different world, man. I said, I want you to come on and play this cat from Baltimore. He was like, for sure. Play it! He played my ex-boyfriend, Piccolo, from Baltimore.
Piccolo.
L to the J. What's happening, baby?
When they wanted to write that role, I was like, this is how it should flow. You know, and it just fit right into the dynamics of our relationship, and it was nothing foreign to either one of us. He was great. I mean, because he was just so authentic and just so real. And like I said, it was just so raw.
Tupac continued to surprise people with a tender performance in the 1993 John Singleton movie Poetic Justice, in which he starred opposite Janet Jackson. Could this be the same man who'd been so scary bad as Bishop in Juice?
Keisha here.
How's my grandbaby doing?
Bad as ever.
Mm-hmm.
I wanted to stay with us for good.
From Juice to Poetic Justice, both of those were Tupac a little bit. You know, they were both certain sides to him. A person just isn't one thing.
As strong as he wasn't afraid to show how vulnerable he was. It was a strength in his vulnerability, and not everybody can do that.
You definitely have to have range. You know, through his music, everybody's seen that he could always make a hard song and then make a compassionate song, so it's only right for him to do that acting.
Once he'd established his range as an actor, Tupac returned to playing tough street guys in movies like Bullet, Gridlocked, and Gang Related, and he won the respect of his fellow actors.
I'd worked with him above the rim, and he was there, man. It was like watching any great, watching Pacino, watching Denzel, watching Tom Hanks. Pac was the same way. You're in a scene, they're in their zone, and you're just really committed, and Pac was committed. Like, when he kicked me on the floor, he really kicked me on the floor.
Get the fuck out! You don't hear me? My stuttering? Get the fuck out, man! Get out!
I didn't really appreciate that too much, but I stayed in character.
Tupac the actor became a new kind of star for a new generation of movie-going youth. And his screen career also encouraged future rap stars to try their hand at acting.
That just made everyone that ever wanted to even think about acting, you know, pursue acting.
Just me watching him and, you know, being a fan, definitely, I, you know, got some tips from him. That did let me know that it could be done. I'm figuring that out now as I get more opportunity to do movies and TV.
This is the show we call Doggy Fizzle.
He definitely showed us there's no real limit. I mean, in the 40s and 50s, a lot of actors and actresses would sing and do variety shows and do movies, have albums, and would just be multi-talented. And it's just been a long time since we had that, and he really lived that up while he was here.
He's a brain actor, and I think had he still been around, it was just a matter of time before he won his Academy.
Looking back now at his brief, tragically abbreviated life, it's clear that the most complex role Tupac ever played was that of himself.
You kind of watched every single step that he made. Every time he did something, he kind of lived a movie, you know? It's like you'd almost wake up every day like, all right, what is Pac gonna do today?
Tupac himself talks about all the things he did and all the thoughts and feelings he had in the gripping new movie Tupac Resurrection, arriving in theaters on November 14th.
I love women. I'm not gonna lie. I love women with a passion. I do. I feel like sometimes now I just be wanting to call Prince and just be like, can we hang? Because I love women like he love women.
Tupac Shakur, the subject of the new documentary Tupac Resurrection, due out November 14th, was a great rapper and a gifted actor, but he was also a tireless opponent of the racial oppression he saw throughout his life and the poverty that fed into it. Tupac knew about growing up poor firsthand.
When I met Pac, he owned two pairs of pants and a sweater. When in his house, he had a mattress on the floor with no sheets. When I say poor, I mean poor. He had nothing.
Listening to him made you see that there's another side, and reality ain't always the, you know, glamorous side of it.
Everybody isn't brought up in those environments, so they're not as conscious. Like, they don't feel as strongly about things as you felt.
Lord knows I tried, been a witness to homicides and drive-bys taking lives, little kids die.
He just took on the world, and I think people connected to that passion. They connected to that heart, to that soul.
Tupac's mother, Afeni Shakur, was a leader in the Black Panther movement in the 1970s, and it was she who fundamentally molded his political consciousness.
I was taught about the movement of Martin Luther King. Pac came in the picture and he schooled me on Malcolm X, the Black Panther Party, and so on and so on and so on. He was the president of the Junior Black Panther Party, and it was something that he lived.
Anybody who didn't listen to Pac and just shrugged off what he was saying was missing something that they could have took with for the rest of their life.
How you gonna be a man and we starving?
Go ahead.
You know? And we have you looking over our five different houses, ain't a man in either one of them motherfuckers. How we gonna be a man?
I think Pac represented, you know, the struggle of a lot of young people in America, particularly young black folks in America.
Pac was definitely an activist. He puts the information in the music.
I hear Brenda's got a baby, but Brenda's barely got a brain. A damn shame, the girl can hardly spell her name. That's not our problem, that's up to Brenda's family. Well, let me show you how it affects our whole community.
There'll always be projects, there'll always be ghettos, there'll always be poverty. And hopefully maybe one day somebody will come along and change that. But until then, we always got his music to remind us of those issues.
Tupac stands out as a warrior. He was always fighting for a cause of freedom. You know, he was just always warring for us and making us understand that he was within the struggle with us.
Tired of being trapped in this vicious cycle. If one more cop harasses me, I just might go psycho.
He stood up against everybody. He stood up against the cops, the way society was, you know, the government, everything. Everything that was fucked up in the world, he would talk about it.
Tupac may have rapped about the everyday struggles faced by black Americans, but his lyrical brilliance and his uncompromising honesty struck a chord with a large white audience as well.
I guess no matter what color you was or where you came from, you felt like you could relate to him. He made you feel like you knew him.
I think he reached a lot of white audiences because that passion is not black or white.
And he wasn't just a gangster rapper either. Tupac's encompassing sensibility gave expression to women's experiences too.
To all the ladies having babies on their own, I know it's kind of rough and you're feeling all alone. Daddy's long gone and he left you by your lonesome. Thanks the Lord for my kids, even if nobody else wants them.
He dealt with the truth and he touched on women having babies too young.
I know you're fed up, ladies, but keep your head up.
Yeah, Keep Your Head Up is a really powerful song. No matter what you're going through, keep your head up.
Tupac Shakur died 7 years ago, but his voice remains, and it still speaks to a new generation.
Man, you could probably start courses off of Tupac in college or somewhere. You could have a whole Tupacology. Brand new science you create over Tupac.
In fact, classes focused on Tupac's work are now being taught at Harvard and the University of California at Berkeley.
I really like this video because it really presents Tupac in a way that a lot of you have never imagined him or thought he would be like.
Tupac's legacy will also live on at the Tupac Amaru Shakur Center for the Arts, which will be built in Atlanta and will expose kids to the arts and encourage individual self-expression.
That means more sometimes than trying to reach a million people, because it's too hard to get your attention across to a million people. If you get to those four or five, it might be a leader in that four or five that can have that voice.
In Tupac Resurrection, Shakur inspires others to rebel against oppression.
I'm doing it for the kid that really lives a thug life and feels like it's hopeless.
Throughout the film, he also expresses a complex understanding of his own life.
The things that people need to know about him, and they need to have a real serious 360-degree understanding of his perspective. I think there was only one size televised, him being cuffed up, him being shot. Tupac always saw a more vivid view. There's a lot of sides to him that I think the world should see.
His influence is so big that it's like everybody is taking something from his music.
I'm proud of his existence and I'm glad I knew him. He was one of the greatest characters ever, the God ever written.
That cat right there, ain't gonna never be nothing like that again.
There is nobody, nobody like that man. I don't care how many records you sell. I don't care how popular you are. There is no comparison, none. And I don't know when there ever will be.
Check it, I grew up, screw up, got introduced to the game, got an ounce of chopping rocks overnight. The Biggie Smalls trying to turn into the Black Frank White.
Even the cops tried to sue me, so what can I do but stay true? Sipping 22s of brew, now the media is trying to test me. Got the press asking questions, trying to stress me. Misery is all I see, that's my mind state. My history with the police to shake the crime rate. My main man had two strikes slip, got arrested and flipped. He screamed thug life and empty the got tired of running from the police.